Where is the arrow moving from?
Bromide ion.
Where is the
to? From the bromide ion to the carbocate ion.
Exactly. From a lone pair on bromide ion, from the lone pair, not from the charge, from any lone pair on bromide ion to carbon. And then what are we forming on the right hand side? What are we forming? By that movement, with those movements of electrons, what are we forming? We're forming a bond between carbon and bromine. Simple. We are explaining this arrow, not the whole molecule. The activity or whatever we have done, the change we have done through this arrow, the double-headed arrow, is to form a bond between C and Br. Simple like that. Not many explanations there. We are forming a bond between C and Br. That's all what I wanted to understand. I can describe this reaction. Listen now, I describe this reaction. And look at your paper. Look on your paper, what you have written there. And I'm doing an explanation. The first step involves attack of hydrogen by the pi electrons. Attack of the pi of H by the pi electrons. Somebody yourself, we don't speak the same way. Somebody can say the pi electrons attack hydrogen. The other one can say attack of hydrogen by the pi electrons. Well, the key word is pi electrons and attack and hydrogen. How you combine them is yourself. To form. Where do I see the word to form? Which symbol represent to form there? On your paper. Which one? Which sign represent to form?
The reaction arrow.
Correct. It's to form, or to give, or to yield, or to afford. Br minus, bromide ion, and a carbocation ion. Okay? You need to know what a carbocation ion is. And you need to know a lot. We do this at first year. I cannot teach you carbocation ion. And now, the second step is that the bromide ion attacks the electron-deficient carbon of the carbocation ion. Which carbon of the carbocation ion is electron-deficient?
B.
Carbon B.
You can't say B. There's no, tell me, it looks unique. There's no longer B on it. You can't keep on labeling every carbon. It is just
the
unique.
Carbon with a positive charge.
Positively charged carbon.
Yes.
To form a bond. That's the mechanism. Okay. Now let's change the mechanism. We're increasing it. We're increasing the size. I'm just increasing the size. I'm replacing one of the hydrogens. That's the second example, okay? The same reaction. Similar reaction. The same reaction, a new one now. You write it afresh, but this time around you replace any of the hydrogens on carbon A with CH3. You replace any of those with CH3. I see three Ramaphosa here. Yeah, what is one thing? Okay. All right. So you replace one of the hydrogens with CH3. Have you done that?
Yes.
And then label those bonds sigma and pi. Designate them sigma or pi. It can be the bottom or the top, doesn't matter, for as long as you know which one is going to react.
Video.
Can you all mute your videos, guys?
Yeah, it's
okay, good. Why is it still showing? Oh, it's still showing that of Ramaphosa. So we are reacting this one this time around with HCl, okay? We are reacting it with HCl. The same, almost the same example, but we have changed HBr into HCl, okay? HCl. This time around, so you can see what I'm writing, right or wrong? Hello? Okay, anyway, it doesn't preclude or prevent me from talking. Again now, write your ACL in such a way that it is a Lewis structure. The Lewis structure of ACL, it must be H, single bond, Cl with three lone pair electrons. Okay? Mute your... guys, we are recording this, but I want you to understand with or without looking here. You look, you use your paper as the board here. Now we have got propene reacting with HCl, okay?
Yes.
If you look at molecule, at the propene, carbon A and carbon B, carbon A and carbon B differ, we agree? They differ. Yes. How, what is the difference between them?
One is attached to two hydrogens, the other is attached to a hydrogen and a metal group.
A metal group.
That is the same thing. Listen carefully. This molecule is not different from the previous one. The only difference is that one, this time around, carbon A has a CH3, yeah, okay? You see that?
Yeah.
The behavior is going to be the same. They're going to behave in a similar way, but the CH3 will bring a difference because it's not the same as H. It's the same between me and you, who are human beings. We behave almost the same, but there's a difference that will come because maybe the other one is a lady and the other one is a guy. The behavior just, we move the same way, the same pattern, but one will move faster than the other. So now let's move the mechanisms. The pi electrons will attack which atom?
Hydrogen.
How many electrons are coming to hydrogen? Two. Okay.
Yeah.
How many electrons were there on hydrogen before this new one? How many are already there on hydrogen?
Two.
Two.
But yeah. Hydrogen can only accommodate two. Is a new Bloom's better, high and fire. I'm sure you cannot have two partners at the same time. That's real life. So the other hydrogen will lose the two electrons to over to which atom?
To chlorine.
To which atom? Why to chlorine, not to you? Why to chlorine but not to you? Why to chlorine and not to you or to anywhere? Say it. But they can't go and listen to me. They can't go anywhere. They can't go anywhere but to chlorine. If you and the person close to you are holding a pen, one is holding the tip of the pen and the other one is end, and one let loose, it will remain with the original partner, right or wrong?
Right.
Do it. Maybe. Hold the pen with your hands, with both your hands. Hold the pen with both your hands. And then consider your left hand as individual A and your right hand as individual B. Hold your pen with both your hands. You consider individual A, your left hand side as individual A, the right hand side as individual B. If A let loose, releases the pen, who remains with the pen?
It's B.
That's just the logic you must apply when you do mechanism. You must account for everything. So now this bond pair electron go to chlorine. They go to the chlorine because it's more electronegative. And then by the three green sides, I'm writing Cl minus first because chlorine has gained electrons fast like that. Now the tricky part here this time is that carbon A and carbon B are not equivalent. They differ. Unlike the previous example, carbon A and carbon B are not equivalent in this case. Let's now take it when hydrogen is attached to carbon A. When hydrogen is attached to carbon A, we're going to have the following. Plus. We agree. Do you agree?
Yes, yes.
And then when it, we're serious here. And then when it is attached to carbon B, it will be CH3, CH, yes, plus, and then CH3, yes. We agree?
Yes.
This is attack on carbon A. This is attack. This is attack on carbon B. Clear? What we call this species, these are not molecules. What we call species A and B, they are not molecules, they are intermediates. What do we generally call them?
The resonance.
They are not resonance. Both of them, you, yourself, myself, and everybody, what are we called? Human beings, right or wrong? Human beings, what we call species A and B. That's what the problem lies. If you don't know terminology, how do you proceed? What do you call H, A and B? I mean, I asked you before, you told me about it, and I said, don't say cation.
Cation.
What do you call A and B?
Yeah.
They're not cation.
Cation.
They're not cation.
What are they?
They're not cation.
Carbocations. Carbocations.
Not carbocations. Guys, can I be honest with you? I'm serious here. You are doing honors. I should not, this is first year chemistry. And I need your participation so that we move forward. We should not be doing first year chemistry. I'm doing it because I noticed some weaknesses in some of your background, almost all of you. And I came down, I want to come down to you, you are playing. Don't do that to me. Please. I drove all the way to so that we can all see. I did not want to do teams because it was going to cut you and then all these things. I want you to follow me. I'm teaching you. And when you leave here, you'll understand everything. So we call them carbocations. Now, which one? There are two. We also got types of carbocations. Remember, they are primary, secondary, tertiary. Which one is carbon number A? Is carbocation number A? What type of carbocation is carbocation number A?
Primary.
Carbocation. It's a primary carbocation. A primary, listen to me. I just don't say primary because primary is the way that, can you mute your phone there? I'm not just simply saying primary. If somebody says what's a primary carbocation, I will say it's a positively charged carbon attached to only one other carbon. You see, is this carbon attached to only this carbon? And what type of a carbocation is number B then?
Secondary
carbocation. What is a secondary carbocation? Looking at it, you don't have to memorize. Looking at it, you can describe it. What is a secondary carbocation?
Attached to two.
What is attached to two? Wait a minute. Call it. When I was a student, can you mute your phone there? When I was a student, I knew I read the book myself, but when the lecturer talks, I listen to the style. What is he saying different from the way I understood? I described this one here. I said a primary carbocation is a positively charged carbon attached to one another carbon, only attached to one other carbon. So what is a secondary carbocation?
Using
the pattern I've given. It's a positively charged
carbon atom attached to
two other carbons. So what will be a tertiary carbocation then?
Attached
it
to three other carbons.
Carbon upon it is, don't simply say attached to three other carbons. What is attached to three other carbons? You must start where? That's your problem of summarizing things. You get zero in the exam because of that. It's a positively charged carbon attached to three other carbons. If you listen, the only difference here was attached to. Throughout I said a positively charged carbon attached to, then that's where the difference is. And when it came to secondary, I said a positively charged carbon attached to two. When it came to the tertiary, a positively charged carbon attached to three. That's the way you should talk. Once you take double ups, chemistry will do the opposite for you. Now, which one is more stable between a primary and a secondary carbocation?
Secondary is more stable.
Secondary.
Why? Why? I know you memorized it at first year. Why? Okay. Because you can see, I'm going to erase one part. I'm sure you have taken that, or maybe I'll use a different color here. Okay. Let me use a different color because this is recorded. If you take CH3, this one here, that's ethane, you agree? That is ethane, you agree?
Yes.
You agree?
Yes.
Hold it. You are going to wait. Out of the 3 hours I've allocated, you might only use 1 hour because you are not proactive. I'm here to help you. I know what I'm doing. I mastered it. So this is carbon one, this is carbon two. Okay? Between carbon one and two, which one is more electronegative?
None.
It's equally the same.
No,
they've got equal electronegativity. Do you agree?
Yes.
We agree they've got equal electronegativity. Yeah.
Yes.
So between carbon one and carbon two, between carbon one and carbon two, which one is electron poor?
None.
They've got equal electron density. Do you agree? Now let us come to. I'm trying to make you come and reason what we mean when we say it's more stable than the other. That's the thing I'm trying to bring you to us.
Yeah,
and I want you to be careful and listen there. Okay, good. Now I'm rewriting this on the same board. On the same board now, I'll use a different color, maybe blue. I'll use blue this time. I write CH3, I write CH2 plus, okay? And then I say this is carbon one, this is carbon two. I'll encircle this in red. Carbon one and two in that red spot, are they equivalent?
No.
What is their difference? By the way, it must be spontaneous. Okay, let me tell you one thing about science. Science is what you see, not what you think, imagine you should be seeing. It's what you see. What's the difference between the two?
One is electron rich, one is electron poor.
There's nothing electron rich. One has got three hydrogens, the other one has got two hydrogens and a charge. We agree? That's what I see. I don't see any poverty or richness there. I see three hydrogens on carbon one, I see two hydrogens on carbon two, and I see a positive charge on carbon two. I said, don't talk about things you don't see. It must be things that you can easily see and point at. All right. Now, between carbon one and two, which one do you think is electron poor?
Carbon two.
Why do you say so?
Because of the positive charge. It has two less electrons
to be in octet state. It's far away from noble gas configuration. You agree? Octet state, by the octet and noble gas is the same thing. The reason I prefer noble gas is because hydrogen resembles helium, and those cannot be octet. It's two, and the others is eight. And when you go further, they're more than eight. That's why we say noble gas configuration. All atoms react to attain the noble gas configuration. That's a rule we read that first year. So which one between carbon one and two do you think is more electronegative? If you understand electronegativity. Which one will be electron pulling? Logic.
Carbon one. Carbon one.
And two. Which one will pull? It can't be carbon one. Which one is poor? Can you steal when you are? No, don't talk about South African corruption. Like, we're talking about a normal situation. If you have enough, can you really continue to take more? No.
No.
Which one between one and two will pull electrons away from the other? Because you can only pull if you are poor. You pull electrons because you are poor. Which one between one and two will pull electrons towards itself?
Carbon two.
How do I show that? Correctly. Good. How do I show that? Small arrow, not a big thing. You cannot have the biggest notes on a small head. You have to be a small arrow showing that two electrons of the bond are flowing toward. They are not on. They are flowing toward CH2. We agree? Now let us come here. Let's come to this one. To this carbocation. You agree that here in this carbocation, you will also have electrons flowing away from this CH2 to that CH2. We agree. This primary carbocation. And then how many arrows will be flowing towards the positive charge in the case of B? How many? How many such arrows?
Two.
Moving from CH3 this way. We agree. We agree. So we are saying, listen carefully. At first here you said, let me give you an example. If you go to the bank, to the ATM, let me put it this way. When you deposit money, you're saying I'm giving money to the bank, right or wrong? That's you relative to the bank. You say I'm giving money to the bank. You agree?
Yes.
Or maybe even a situation of ATM. When you take money from the ATM, what are you saying? You say I'm withdrawing money. We agree?
Yes.
Right. But what is the ATM doing to you? Is it not donating money to you?
Yes.
Is it not giving money to you? You see, it's relative. I say I'm stronger than you. I'm stronger than you. You can say I'm weaker than you. It depends, relative. So how many donating groups are around the positive carbon here? In the case of primary, how many donating groups? How many?
One.
Correct. How many donating groups are on B?
There are two.
Two. So there are two. Which one has more donors?
Second.
A or B? What is the second one? I'm asking you a question. You are using your own words. Can you mute your phone on the other side? A or B?
It's B.
It's B. So between B and A, we're talking about the positive carbon. We're talking about the central carbon, positive carbon in that case, and positive in this case. Which one do you think is more poor between A and B?
A.
Why? Because if you get one cent from one person, and the other one gets one cent from two people, who has more money?
The one who gets from two people.
Yes. So which one would be less positive between A and B? By the way, electrons, if you donate electrons towards the positive charge, they reduce, they don't remove it. If I give you a cent, I have not removed your poverty. I've just relieved you. You're still poor. I've not removed your poverty. You're still poor. I've just reduced your poverty. So which one between A and B? Which one between A and B is more positive? Which one between A and B is more positive?
A.
Which one between A and B is more positive? Why? Because you only have one group. So yes, it's more positive than B. And B is less positive than A. You agree? So which one between A and B will be more stable? Stability. Stability is towards noble gas configuration. It's towards noble gas configuration. If you have no cent, you are poor, you are there. I give you a cent, you are going towards richness, but you are far away from me. You are still very far. You are better than yesterday. Which one between A and B is more stable?
B.
It's because B is no longer at 6. It is 6.5 or 6, yeah, 6 or 7. It's towards 8. Whereas A is just little bit, moving away from 0 towards a situation. So that is why, now let me come back and remind you that your lecturer did not tell you. We are saying the alkyl groups when bonded to a carbon are electron donating. No, they're electron donating. Yes, you can't donate unless there is a pool. For every force of action, there's a reaction. So you donate because there's a pool. So the positive carbon is pulling electrons away from the CH3s. So it's pulling from two, reducing its positive character. Whereas that side, the primary one is pulling from only one carbon, reducing the positive character to a limited extent. So between the two, one is less stable than two. So two is the one that is going to form the both of them will form, but two is the one that is going to form more prolats. So now the next step is that CL has the opportunity to can attack here. This CL can attack here, all right? Or CL, the same CL can come and attack this carbocation. So there are two options. How many products are you going to form?
Two.
From this reaction, from this step, two products. One has CL at the terminal point, that is A, and then one has a CL in the middle, that is B. I'm not going to write it. You have to finish it. Finish it on paper. I'll ask you a question, a follow-up question. So what is the name of product A? What is the IUPAC name of product A?
1-chloro-pentane.
Help, lady.
Propane.
It's what?
Propane.
Say it. 1-chloro what? Colleague. Can you see why? All right. Yeah, correct. It's 1-chloropropane. And the other one would be 2-chloropropane. The reason I started you with first year, I wanted to show you that knowledge of first year is more important even beyond doctoral level. We are talking about an atom from grade 10 up to beyond doctoral level. So which means what you learned at first year you must remember now. Unfortunately, that is chemistry. So now, which one is going to be the major product between 2-chloro and 1-chloropropane? Which one is going to be the major product?
2-chloropropane.
Major means 2-chloro. Why 2-chloro, I agree. Why is it a major product? Why is it a major product? Because it's forming from a more stable secondary carbocation. Do you see that? The reason is because it's forming from a more stable secondary carbocation. And this one will be minor because it's forming from a less stable secondary carbocation. Understand, reactions are this way, colleagues. They're like you crossing a river. You move from point A on the riverbank, the riverside. You want to cross. What are you going to use to cross a river? What do we usually build in between to enable us to cross a river?
Bridge.
You don't know. A bridge. Can you cross if your bridge is weak?
No.
Chances are you might, but you will have battles because somewhere you must keep on saying, returning, fearing, jumping, and so on. But if the bridge is stable, you will be able to reach the other side. Is that clear? So the intermediate, these carbocations, if you know your science, are the ones which will tell you that you are going to get product A. You can determine which product you are going to get from there. Let me do a similar example again, but this time using hydrogen peroxide. And then I'll tell you why I've done many examples that are related, so that when you look at them, all of them, you'll notice that we're doing the same thing. Nothing changes, just changing of one molecule or so. Mute it.
Okay, guys, just make sure you're with on mobile phone. Just make sure your video is off. Yeah, thanks. Because we don't need to see you at the moment.
You see what the molecule I've written on the board? That is a question for you to answer. Okay, maybe? Oh, yes. No. Let me remove H. Okay, I'll come back to that one. No, this one is equivalent. It's too equivalent. Sorry. I must put H again. Sorry. Apology for that. I just want to show you, just to reiterate what we're doing. My first thing, if a question is asked that propose a mechanism for the reaction of propene and hydrogen iodide, the first thing I'll draw my propene, I'll label my pi and sigma bond because I know I'm going to use them. And then now I'll come to hydrogen iodide and say, no, no, no. Professor said it's incomplete until I put the lone pair electrons, three of them, and I put partial negative, partial positive. This size, this alpha, sigma, and then delta plus and delta negative speak by themselves. They have got a language. This means the pi electrons will have to attack, but they just don't attack anywhere. They will attack the hydrogen. Two of them are attacking, and then and so on. But then my question is, I've got hydrogen one, I mean carbon, I will number them this way this time around. I've got carbon two and carbon one. Each one of them can, I'm going to dictate this so that you write it on paper and notice how simple these things are. Two electrons are coming away from, I mean, are coming from the pi electrons. And that pi bond belongs equally to carbon number two and number one. Is that clear? If you have a question, yes. Unmute and ask, and then we'll address your question. If you have a comment, also you can do that. So let me give you an example. A typical example in life, I gave you about a child. It's you and your partner, a lady and a gentleman, female and male or spouses. You have a car. Let me just use a luxury car because you all like those, Mercedes or Jaguar. Can you drive it the same way? I mean, you and another person, whether it's a male or a female, there's no way you can drive the car, same speed, same everything, you're different. You can drive the same, I mean, in a similar way, but not equally so. So if you take that car, it belongs equally to you. You drive it as a lady. You probably drive nice, slow, nicely, you know, very, very, you'll treat it like a luxury car. Then you give it to your partner, a male one. You'll definitely put some more pressure to the fuel to move. You can't drive it equally, but yet it belongs equally to you. So you can use it. The other day, one of you uses it, and the other one is the other. So what I'm trying to say is like a child. When the child moves the mother, if it's a girl, will be more comfortable with the mother because they will do a similar hairstyle and so on. And then I move with my daughter. Along the way, I meet my friends. You'll be a little bit bored to say they're talking gentlemen's language and so on. But it's still our child. Carbon 1 has got the right to use the pi electrons. Carbon number 2 has got the right to use those pi electrons. But they can't use them equally because the two carbons differ. One has two hydrogens. The other one has a CH3 in addition. I mean, it has in place of one of the hydrogens. It means they are not symmetrical, they cannot be the same. One day, that hydrogen can attach to carbon one, then we're going to form a secondary carbocation. If it attaches to carbon number two, we're going to form a primary carbocation. And the reaction mechanism is same as before. I give you a minute to finish it. You tell me the names of the molecules, and I'll explain. Take it from here. Whoever finishes first must tell me the names of the molecules. What are the names of the molecules?
One iodopropane and two iodopropane.
Which one would be the major product?
Two iodopropane.
Why? Why?
Because it's formed from a more stable carbocation.
Which type of carbocation? You must now name it. Without putting the name, they are both formed from carbocation. Yeah, which is most correct. If you have that on your nose and you continue that way, you are a chemist. Let me go to another example. We use the same example this time around. And here you must take notes whether you like it or not. You must take the notes because this is more important than honors level. The molecule is iodine, you agree? This is iodine molecule. What you need to realize there is that if these are electrons, okay, lone pair electrons, But electrons are not, we designated them as double, double, double on paper. Basically, electrons are moving like a cloud. Like, no, let me put it here. A cloud, 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 like in this way. A lot of electrons around this, like a ball of rugby, a symmetrical ball, a rugby ball, like a rugby ball. You see that? This is one, it's one iodine atom. I've not put the dots. This is just electron cloud. And this is the second iodine molecule. I mean iodine atom. If you look at this ball, a rugby ball is symmetrical. You agree?
Yes.
Yes. The shape is always symmetrical. That both sides look, the shape just look the same. I mean both ends of that thing. And imagine this like a symmetrical balloon. A symmetrical balloon, maybe the balloon, this is the mouth of the balloon. The balloon is still this way. The balloon is still this way, and then here you blow the air. What will happen to point A and point B if you inflate a balloon? What happens to A and B? A balloon, you know a balloon. All of you have one way or another got a balloon from a steak ranch during your birthdays, or you bought them for other things and you have seen them before. What happens if you inflate that balloon?
Inflate. Expand.
Expand. Which part expands? Which part expands? Which part expands? This is your mouth here. I said this is your mouth. It's you with your mouth. Which one will expand?
B first.
Which one will expand? B will expand. B, you agree? If we inflate it, B will expand. You agree? Like that. Is that clear? Is it? You agree?
Yes.
Remember that these are gas, you are inflating gas molecules. It's gas molecules. Which point between A and B will have more gas molecules?
Yeah.
B, you agree? Alright. If we agree that electrons are like gas molecules around there, and then you are bringing two electrons, and they don't turn back. Remember these are electrons. What's the charge of an electron?
Negative.
Minus.
Negative. You are bringing negative here. This is negative. You agree, negative charge. And then this is negatively charged throughout, symmetrically. You are bringing these two electrons towards A, to iodine A and iodine B. And iodine B, the cloud is like that of a balloon. Where will the electrons go to?
Towards B.
They'll go towards B.
They'll go towards B, you agree? They'll go towards B in such a way that I'm just redrawing it and going back. So basically, this will be like that. We agree? Something like this. We agree? So which one between A and B will be electron poor, and which one will be electron poor between A and B?
A.
A
will be slightly positive, and then B will be slightly negative. We agree? Do we? So listen and take it down. I wanted to show you that only the carbon-carbon, only the carbon-carbon pi bonds, whether they are from carbonyl, alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound or enols, or only the carbon-carbon pi bonds can polarize iodine. Remember, iodine molecule is nonpolar. We agree it's nonpolar. By itself, it's nonpolar. But when these electrons are approaching one end of the iodine, they will push the electron density away from this iodine to the other side. So this becomes slightly positive, the other one will be slightly negative. Do you see that?
Yes.
So it is now suddenly it is polar. You see that? We have polarized it. But not any other electrons can polarize it. Only the carbon-carbon pi bonds. Do you hear what I'm saying? And this is what you need to honors when you do reactions like some in the assignment, who do what, whatever, who do what prevot and so on. This is how it goes. Which electrons polarizes a halogen molecule? Remember, I'm referring to iodine here. It can be chlorine, it can also be bromine. Which electrons polarizes a halogen molecule? Which electrons polarizes a halogen molecule? X. X2.
Carbon pi bond.
Carbon pi bonds. You agree? Pi electrons. Mm-hmm. Only those ones. All right. So with this understanding, you extend that to one of your to several questions in your assignment. I think it's 1 and 2, or both of them, or in assignment 2. Now we've got an iodine. So you write it this way. Partial positive, partial negative on paper. In a second or a minute, you write it that way, and the pi electrons will attack this iodine from the back, okay? From the back. And this one will leave from the other side onto there. Simple logic, if you have got a company and your workers want to go on industrial strike and you want to continue with your activity, if you have 2 gates and the permanent staff members that are doing outside, there's no way you can bus in, transport in the skeleton, the temporary staff through the same gate. They must come from the back. If a lion enters through the door where you are now, I'm sure you're going to get out through the opposite window, right or wrong?
Why?
Can you get why? Because if you confront it, there's going to be an increase in energy. The unstable situation is going to bind you. It's just going to maul you and kill you. So if you bring the negatively charged electrons cannot live on the same side as the outgoing electrons because they are both negatively charged. They'll repel. That's why we say S and G, you attack from the back and the other one leaves from the front or vice versa. Higher and fire, the other side. So now we're going this way, okay? Let me attach for now. I'm attaching, remember this is the same mechanism as before. Iodine atom A can attach equally to carbon 2 or carbon 1. It can attach equally. You agree? Because the pi bonds belong equally to this carbon. Sure. Let's attach it to carbon. Preferably, it will attach to carbon number 1 so that it forms a secondary carbocation. It will attach that way. It's H, another H which was there. And then we've got the iodine. How many lone pair electrons are on this iodine written in green? How many lone? There were 3 here. No. I'm talking about, okay, there were 3. How many lone pairs will you have around this iodine?
Three.
That's still 3, you agree? Mm-hmm. What happened to the other part? The other one is this formation of this bond. You agree? This bond here comes from the pi electron. And then it will be plus I minus. How many lone pairs around this I minus?
4.
It's 1, 2, 3, 4. You account for that. You don't mean them on the way. Now, let's come to this carbocation. Let's come to this carbocation here. There's something I've omitted. When iodine attaches to this carbon, when iodine attaches to carbon 1, what remains on carbon 2? Nothing, you agree? How many valence electrons will be around? Around carbon 2.
6.
How many pairs?
6 electrons. 3 pairs.
3 pairs, you agree. So how many is it running? How many is that carbon running short of?
A pair. 2 electrons.
So it will be, what charge will be on it?
A plus.
Be careful. There's a plus, there's a positive. What charge will be on carbon?
Positive
charge. There's no plus charge, it's positive charge. Plus and you and me, plus. Be careful when you use this word because they are very important. If you misuse English, then the science becomes the opposite of what you want. So this will be positively charged. But on any atom, electrons are accommodated into orbitals. You agree? So here you have an empty p orbital. You have an empty p orbital with a low above and below that carbon. And this is just a charge. This is just a positive charge. So if it's empty, how many electrons can be accommodated into this p orbital? How many electrons? With opposite spins, how many?
Two.
Mm-hmm. Now, correct, it's two. Look here, you always write the mechanism the opposite way. I want to show you how the hydrogenium comes. You have got an electron poor orbital here, next to an electron rich orbital here. The two will interact. They will interact. You remember, it's poor closer to rich. They will definitely, the poor will steal from you. When you eat them hungry, they'll just pull you, will share the plate by hooker by crooker. So let's go this way. Now you are going to have CH3, C, and you must listen carefully here again. CH2, I'm summarizing that. I don't encourage you to write CH2, CH2. Well, you are starting to write this single bond so that you can see when you are wrong. I can do this because I know better. How many lone pairs will be around I this time? In the green structure. How many lone pairs will be around I? How many? Say it loudly. The faster and the loud, the more loud you say it, the more the understanding.
Two lone pairs.
Two, good. Speak that way throughout. What do I expect here? It was neutral here. It used the lone pair to make a bond. What will be the charge then?
Positive.
Look here. Gain of electron is negative. Loss, negative, positive. So it will be positive. You agree? Now let's look here. What? Do you agree with me? Let me erase this for now so that you don't. I can deliver the message correctly. If you look here, let's look at what we call the species with an iodine and there's also a positive charge. What do you call them? Say it.
Alkyl halides.
Aye, man. Aye. You look at the only unique thing that makes that whole molecule unique is that positive charge. What do you call them?
A carbocation.
It's a carbocation. Ignore the incorporation. It's a carbocation. It's not a molecule, it's an intermediate. It's a bridge between the starting materials and the product. So let us look at carbon number one of this carbocation. How many electrons does it have in total around itself? Carbon number one is the one where iodine is bonded.
Eight electrons, four pairs.
Eight electrons, correct. Eight. That's enough, eight electrons or four pairs. And then let's look at carbon number two with a lobe above and below. How many valence electrons do you have there?
Six.
So, but what type of a carbocation is this one? Okay, fine, six, I agree with you. But what type of a carbocation is this?
A secondary.
Secondary. It's more,
yes.
We always say secondary, it's correct. You are perfect. It's secondary. It should be more stable than if you attached iodine here, we agree. Your data will be primary. But can I tell you that this one here, I'm going to draw it with an asterisk in blue. This iodinium ion versus this one. One will be A and then one will be B. Which one do you think is more stable and why? I say B is the most stable. It's more stable. And why? Why is B more stable than A? This is why I want you to take notes or you lose. If you lose here, you lose most of the things in that organic chemistry assignment. Why is B more stable than A? Or perhaps let me ask you this question. When atoms react, bond formation, bond breakage, which state do they want to attain?
Noble gas,
there's nothing like lower state, noble gas configuration, which means octet state for any atom other than hydrogen. We agree?
Yes.
So how many electrons are around each atom? Ignore the hydrogens on species B. Just count how many bonds are around that. Maybe let me write it this way. Ignore the hydrogens. I'm going to ignore the hydrogens for in the counting. Wait a minute. I'm saying in counting of the stability. How many electrons are around the carbon written in blue in the in under A, under B?
Eight.
How many bonds are around this? Eight. How many? Oh. How, yes, correct. There are eight. 2, 4, 6, 8. Each bond contains two electrons, by the way. Each line is representing two electrons. And then now the middle carbon, how many? No, there's something missing on the middle one. Remember, it had the hydrogen here. It had this H, sorry. Correct. How many bonds are around that carbon? The one I just inserted H.
Four bonds.
Four. How many electrons?
Electron.
Yes. So how many electrons? Eight. Now let us go to the positively. Let's go to the positively charged iodine atom. How many electrons are around it in total?
Eight.
Eight. You must listen. You know what I'll tell you, all of you? You don't fail chemistry because it's difficult. First of all, you have a problem in interpretation of the questions. I say to you, what is your name? And then say, no, my mother is Johanna. I'll kick you. Just say, I'm Kaya Licha. It's your name. Not you, I was second born, third born. That's not your name. Say it without fear. So how many electrons in total are around I in structure B? Eight. Four of them are non-bonding. You agree? And the other four are in the bonds. We agree?
Yes.
So let's compare back with structure A. In structure A, there's an atom that is not in noble gas state. Which one is it in structure A?
Carbon.
Carbon. Guys, this is science. This is science. If you ask me what I wear, I say white lab coat. I can say you're wearing a jazz, like white lab coat, full stop. Which carbon? The carbon is unique. You must count everything that will make me go to that carbon and not nowhere else but to that carbon. Which carbon is that?
Positively charged
carbon.
That's what you should have said. I don't look anywhere. I look at the positive, I see the carbon. That's what we say in science. The one that is not in noble gas configuration is the positively charged carbon. But when you look at it under B, it is in noble gas configuration. So between A and B, which one is the most stable state?
B.
B, why? Why?
All atoms, including
the positively charged iodine atom, are in noble gas configuration. Very stable and preferred. Only then do you bring, I'm erased because the body is small. You write on paper and extend from there. Only then can you bring a nucleophile. Can you bring a nucleophile to attack either yeah, on this carbon. Yeah, it can move. Calm down. So, like this. The nucleophile, only then a nucleophile can attack either this carbon or that. And if it attacks it, it will attack differently from the opposite side of this of the iodine. So if it attacks, let's say this is attack A. So this bond A will open over to iodine. Two electrons will go to iodine. You agree? Then if it opens through B, then this bond will go to, it's B prime, will go there. So you've got two possibilities. The preferred attack will be the less sterically hindered one. So if you go to your assignment for the Woodwards, where you see iodine, there are three questions that were related there. And all of them, you started wrong. This one, this iodonium ion forms after that. You must include this first. And tell me why this one is more stable than the other. Can you tell me why A is more stable and preferred than A? Why B is more stable and preferred than A? Can you tell me? Try it. You said it before anyway. Say it again.
What was the question?
I'm saying why is B preferred than A?
I say it was because all the atoms have attained the noble gas Configuration.
Configuration. Or state. If you forgot for configuration, you say state. That's it. Perfect. And then from there you take over. But what I want you to realize, if you look at the example where we started from, ethane reacting with HBr, and then propene reacting with HCl, and then propene reacting with a HI, and including propene reacting with iodine, the mechanism is similar. Do you notice that? The only difference is on when you have halogen, the difference is brought by this part. The difference is brought by this part. The proximity of an electron rich and an electron poor center close to each other to form that, but the rest of the mechanism is the same. It's just push, pull. Any question? I'm jumping now. I'm going further to other. I'm teaching you first year, but it's more applicable to honors and beyond. All right. Are we together? If we are not together, ask. Only tomorrow will we do things like spectroscopy and so on. Today I'm teaching you what I want you to teach you. Let's go to resonance structures. It's the topic, resonance structures. This is movie magic. Let's go to resonance structures. Okay. Before I go to resonance structures, I want to go back to. You remember I said to you, if you have got CH3, and then you've got H, and then you've got the carbocation. Raise it, my friend, I like questions. Ask me my name.
The previous example that you showed us, you sort of...
That? Yes.
Yeah, you compared it to question one of the first assignment. Am I correct?
I think it's two, okay. assignment two or one, somewhere there, where you are doing the pre-vote, yeah? I don't have my assignment questions with me here.
To me, they look quite different, because the other one sort of says like a carbonyl group. So that's why I'm sort of getting confused if you're sort of comparing the two.
What do you mean?
If you're comparing
it to question one... Describe it and write it on the board. Wait a minute, wait a minute. I said it's one of the questions, and I said it's Woodward or Prevost acetylation, hydrolysis, in the presence of iodine. And there's another mechanism where we use iodine. It might be question assignment two or one, but it's not question one.
Okay, no, never mind then. I thought you were comparing it to question one, and
Say, open your assignment, the summer we used iodine, and I was saying to you, you'll get zero if you do this, you push this pi electrons, you push this pi electron to iodine, and then you get this. You suddenly get I, C plus, and so on. You'll get zero for that. It comes through the carbocation.
Okay.
That's what they wanted to deliver.
Okay, no, I remember the question. Okay, no, it's fine.
Yeah. And I also wanted to deliver to you why iodine being iodine molecule being non-polar, it suddenly gets polar. Which electron did I say polarized iodine molecule or chlorine or whatever?
Pi bond electrons.
Only those can polarize this molecule, whether it's bromine or whatever. Only those. So you know why I'm saying this. When you do carbonyl compounds, I'll come to an example if it so happens that we come there. Let's say you have got the following. It's an enolate ion. You've got this. And then you've got H. You've got H versus O. C. H, maybe CH2 negative. These are resonance structures, you agree? These are resonance structures. And then this is resonance A. This is resonance A. And then this is resonance B. In your mechanism, which one between A and B can react with iodine?
A.
Which one between A? Why?